System failover is one of the key features afforded by Enterprise Manager. A failover may be performed automatically by the system when a server goes offline, or it may be triggered manually. When creating a failover group, you will have at least one spare server that is idle most of the time. It isn't recording any cameras or triggering events. You will then designate the server or servers it will protect if they should go offline. The spare will take over recording duties when a recording server goes offline. Returning to a familiar example we've used in several videos, this Enterprise Manager instance represents a school district. Here we've placed two servers in our high school server group. They've been conveniently named Failer and Spare, so you can see what is going on. But the system names do not matter. To configure failover, you must first create a failover group. Navigate to the Failover Groups page, where there are currently no failover groups configured, and click the Add Failover Group link. You may give the failover group a descriptive name. Here we'll just call this High School Failover. In the previous videos, we've mentioned that servers are added to groups, but the failover group you create does not have to be limited to those server groups. For example, you could conceivably have a spare server at the corporate office that acts as the failover for a satellite office, and they do not even need to be in the same server groups within Enterprise Manager. A key factor is that any spare server must have a network pathway to connect to the cameras or integrated systems. It won't do you any good if the spare is told to take over recording for the cameras for an offline server if the spare system cannot connect to the same cameras. So regardless of where the servers are located, they need a network connection to any devices necessary to protect. Below the name of the failover group, we use the drop-down menu to select our system named Spare. Again, this is simply named Spare for the sake of showing what we are doing. You may have more than one spare server in a failover group if you wish. This could be desired if you are attempting to protect many systems in the same group, and more than one could potentially go offline at the same time. Once a spare is chosen, you will select the server or servers you wish the spare systems to protect. Here, we have only one to protect, with Failer in its name to indicate which system is which in our demonstration. The final field sets the timeout period that Enterprise Manager will wait after detecting a protected system has gone offline before performing the failover. It is recommended not to set this value too low in order to prevent unwanted failover activity. Save the changes, and we now see that our high school failover group has one spare system protecting one server. In larger organizations, you may create multiple failover groups if desired. If a protected server or the failover group displays failover compatibility issues, you may need to investigate the systems in your failover group to correct potential problems. Protected servers and spare servers should be on the same ExacqVision server software version and have the same plugins installed. If a spare server is licensed for only 10 cameras and a protected server is licensed for 20 cameras, the spare will only be able to record the first 10 cameras it connects to during failover. A spare machine that has less memory or hard drive space may have reduced performance than that of the failed server. Systems with early versions of ExacqVision or ExacqVision Edge devices that do not support failover will be listed as not supported. So what happens during a failover? If Enterprise Manager should detect that our protected server was offline after the 30-second timeout, the configuration of that server, which has been copied by the Enterprise Manager, would be applied to the spare server. This includes the network IP addresses, the camera names, even the system name. This spare system would act as though it is the protected system and connect to the cameras as if it were as well. The video will then be recorded to the spare system. When Enterprise Manager detects that the protected system is back online, the process reverses and the configuration returns to the original system and recording resumes on the protected system. An administrator can test this by powering down their protected server or disconnecting it from the network to watch this in action. But here, let's pretend some issue has arisen, and we want to tell Enterprise Manager to manually fail over so we can continue recording video while performing work on the protected system. From the Servers page, we select a protected server to view the Server Details page. The toolbar now displays an icon of a wrench. Click this icon. Our dialog window will list available spares to fail over to, which also lets you know that more than one spare can be designated in a failover group. Click the Failover button. Our server action quickly indicated a failover status is pending, then moments later updates again. It now shows us the status of failed over to and shows the system name. Note that the system name is no longer just spare. It has taken the name of the server it is replacing because Enterprise Manager applied the system configuration to it. If we return to our server's page, you will see this in effect. We could now power down the original machine and perform maintenance on it if we wished while our spare performs the duties of recording video. To perform a failback, we navigate to the spare machine. Note the failover status reads spare in use. Use the failback icon from the toolbar to initiate the release of the spare system. If using server versions 19.09 or higher, combined with Enterprise Manager 19.09 or higher, when a failback occurs, Enterprise Manager will also attempt to move the video it recorded over to the original machine to backfill the time period it was offline. This progress will take some time depending on how much video there is to move. When finished, the spare system status will return to spare standby, indicating it is in standby mode for another failover event. Systems with older versions will retain the recorded video on the spare system.